raised right here in this great city of Detroit, a city that I am very proud of, a city where the daughter of an orphan teen mom grew up to be an entrepreneur, a vice president at Michigan's largest base bank, a mom, hey Jada, an advocate for financial literacy, and a speaker here today at TEDx Detroit. But I wasn't always interested in finance. To be honest, I don't know that I've ever heard one kid say they wanted to be a banker when they grew up. Personal finance is not something that was taught to me in school. It was vaguely talked about at home. Most of what I learned actually came from what I observed in my environment and from my mom. My 16-year career in the financial services industry actually started from a series of financial mistakes. Mistakes that we've probably all made. So today, over these next 7.5 minutes, I'm going to share with you guys some lessons I learned from being miseducated. Being miseducated is sometimes more harmful than being uneducated. Now let me clarify. You see, when we are uneducated, we pause. We ask questions. We're receptive to that information. When we are miseducated, this happens. You see, when we are miseducated, we act. And we act confidently. We think we know. Sometimes we will even argue our point unaware that we have absolutely no idea what we're talking about. People come into the bank every day confidently having no idea what they're doing. And we all come from different environments. I grew up in a household with my mom and my 2 younger brothers. My mother was an orphan and a teen mom. So of course, her financial experiences were much different than what would be that of most of our life. She taught me some good things, she taught me some bad. She taught us things that I don't even think she realized or intended to teach us. When my brothers and I would ask for things, one of her common responses would be, "When I got paid. You can get it when I get paid. We can do that when I get paid. We'll go when I get paid." So much so that we began to anticipate her pay dates. We had a whole list of stuff lined up that we wanted to do on her pay date. We were living paycheck to paycheck and we were kids. Career Builder recently released a study stating that 78% of Americans are living paycheck to paycheck. We are one unexpected expense away from a financial emergency. Payday loan stores are now more popular. There are more payday loan stores in America than McDonald's. Why? Because those unexpected expenses come up. And so what's happening is that we're borrowing money at a ridiculous interest rate because we're unprepared. Payday loan industries are now a $46 billion industry. So some of you may be thinking, well, that's not me. Well, it's certainly somebody because they're making $46 billion a year on payday loans. Those unexpected expenses add up. They're causing us financial emergencies. We have to change our conversations. Simple things, like when I get paid. And we all splurge. I typically get my best lunch on payday. By the end of that next week, probably eating noodles. So, my mom taught me some good things as well. She actively talked about credit in our household. She even added me as an authorized user on her credit card when I was in the 12th grade to boost my credit score. And it worked. It worked so much so that by the time I came home after my first year of college, I had $6,000 in credit card debt and a bunch of free t-shirts and all of this stuff that people had gave me to get them. I was getting credit card offers from every company under the sun. I came home and she was pissed. She said, "You're getting a job." So that job is what began my now 16-year career in banking. I got my first job as a teller. And so it took me 8 months and an IRS tax refund to pay off those credit cards. And that may not seem that bad, but to a college student working full-time just to have enough money to pay for purchases I didn't even remember was torture. And so I said, you know what? Paid those off, closed them out. I had no idea closing out your credit cards would ruin your credit score. My credit score tanked. Larry King Live recently released a report that said 1 in 3 Americans have a low credit score. The average credit score here in the city of Detroit is a 608, which by many measures is deemed poor. We have a poor credit ranking, I believe largely in part to the fact that we don't know what we're doing. How was I supposed to know closing my credit cards would ruin my credit score? Seemed like it made sense. I didn't want to get in trouble again. I closed them out. Now, my credit score is ruined. So here I am, sitting in a banking center, doing hundreds of transactions every day, making recommendations to people, and I was completely unaware of how to manage my own finances. So what did I do? I started listening. I realized that I had no idea what I was doing. I realized some of the things that I had been taught were wrong. I started asking questions. There's experts all around us. There's people who know these things. You know how many people work in one banking center? I had no idea what some of those people did. People were talking about investments. I had never heard of some of those things growing up. So I started asking questions, seeking advice. I was in an environment where there were all different types of people coming in. So I started learning from those people. Once I rebuilt my credit, the very first thing that I did was change my mindset. And instead of incurring debt, I incurred an asset. And I became a homeowner at the age of 22. Today, I own 10. A client of mine came in and he was doing a withdrawal off a line of credit. And I said, hey, you know, what are you using this money for? He said, I'm using it to start a business for my son. And it was just that simple. I know a lot of people who are trying to start businesses today and have absolutely nowhere to go because they don't have access to money. So what did I do? I went and took out a personal loan. I bought what was my first investment property. $3,250 has now turned me into the last 6 years, $75,000 in income. I went from using my credit to incur a bill to incurring income. And as I learned, I taught people. I started speaking about it. Did you guys know I did this? I started investing with my mom. I started investing with my brothers. Most recently, me and my 13-year-old daughter just acquired her first investment property. College is not going to pay for itself. Finances are evolving. Like everything else, the way we spend money, the way we earn money has changed. When I first started in banking, there were things like Series E bonds. That was a very popular thing. Buy a savings bond. Today, we don't even offer those things. People are investing in stuff like cryptocurrency. I don't even know what that is. And I work in a bank every day. So, in closing, I just want to leave you guys with a couple of things. A, we have to first understand that there are things that we just don't know. Some of the things that we do know were we were taught incorrectly, or the time has changed. We have to relook at our conversations about money, some of the simple conversations. We have to be open to communicating about it, good and bad. We have to seek advice. There are experts out there that do these things every day. Finances are evolving. We have to evolve with it. And as we learn, as we get the information, we have to teach others. Thank you.